As you know, this morning, the district attorney sent another missive to city officials, and I thought it was important that I take some time this morning to calmly respond to his letter. Let me begin by saying I hate having a public confrontation with another elected official, because I know what people say. They say, it's politicians squabbling again. It's not my way. It never has been my way. It's not the way I like to handle my business. But sometimes you don't have a choice. Today, the district attorney put out his second letter in the last 6 weeks, threatening to prosecute city officials, and this time demanding that the city attorney hire more attorneys to prosecute violators of the law living in homeless encampments. The first time I ignored his threat. This time I will not. Mr. District Attorney, prosecuting violators, respectfully, that is your job. The city does not prosecute crimes. The city attorney has no authority to prosecute misdemeanor crimes. That is a fact. Mr. Ho, I understand your frustration. We are all frustrated. But some of us are actually working day and night to try to make the problem better. You are going about this all wrong. This is pure politics and beneath the honor of your office. As you listen to your operatives, they are misleading you. This should not be a wedge political issue. It's too important. Human lives and the safety, the health and safety of our community and its future are not political soundbites. 2 weeks ago, I sat in your office. I reached out. I sat in your office and made a good faith proposal for real partnership. I didn't make it public and expected you would reach out to meet again. Your political stunt today, the second such stunt in little over a month, is bad faith. Your public posture is at best disingenuous and at worst dangerous. Mr. Ho, you seem to want to abdicate your job to me, the city attorney, and to the city. Please, sir, do your job. Let me tell the public now what I offered to you between leaders and the game that you are currently playing. It was contained on my letterhead with dated July the 26th, with 10 substantive points that I asked you to consider. I'm making this public, of course, today. I put my proposal together, not alone, but with the full input of our police chief and the city attorney, and gave it to you with a full explanation. Remember it being an hour or so long conversation in your office again on the 26th of July. Let me say before I go over this that I do not believe and have never believed that being homeless is a crime, nor should it be a crime. But I also feel strongly, and have articulated it from this dais many times, that whatever will work to make our city safer and cleaner, and whatever it will take to get people who are really sick into care and treatment, is worth just about any strategy, even if that strategy is controversial. So here was the trade-off that I offered you, and my offer still stands. I said the following. I would create some discomfort in my end of the world by stating publicly that I would be in favor of the police department actually arresting people for misdemeanor crimes petty theft, drug crimes, people living in these encampments. If in exchange, you would actually agree to prosecute and you were willing to offer diversion into mental health and substance abuse treatment for people who so desperately need the help and who are not getting the help. That was the basis of my offer. I also asked if you would partner with me to work with the Sacramento Superior Courts to get them to actually increase and increase in a substantive way the number of collaborative courts that they are offering. Because frankly, Judge Larry Brown is an absolute gem for our county, but one judge, collaborative court, is not nearly enough for the need and what's going on out in our streets. I asked you if you would fully back me and the city to push the county, which is absent from any of your letters, to actually implement the partnership agreement that we reached with the county at the end of 2022. Why is that so important? I've talked frequently over the last couple of weeks about my disappointment that the most high profile engagement we made in the city of Sacramento between the city and county was 28th and C. Several months, 30 people, over 800 syringes found, and one person enrolled in comprehensive care and treatment. We need your help, Mr. District Attorney, to make sure that that partnership agreement actually works. And finally, there were 10 points, I won't go through them all. I asked you if you would fund community prosecutors who are actually dedicated full-time to the kind of trade-off that I offered earlier in my letter. The DA provides one community prosecutor for the downtown. You charge us big money to do so. When I asked you and when we asked you if you would fund a community prosecutor in four parts of the city, your response was you would consider it, but only if the city would pay $1 million a prosecutor for 3 years. That's not partnership. Your response to my private entreaty to you to work together was clear and is clear. No, 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 and no. You cleverly, and maybe too cleverly by half, seek to turn it around. Let's have the city prosecute people. Let's have the city divert people into treatment, even though the city has no authority over services. Here's what the city actually did last Tuesday, and why your letter, let's just say, is a day or maybe a week late. You instruct us to set up temporary sites. That's exactly what we're doing, and authorized the city manager last week to do so, and he's already hard at work implementing the council decision. You instruct us to use a coordinated access system. We funded it over a year ago. You demand an enforcement protocol. We have an enforcement protocol. Last Tuesday, we strengthened it significantly. This is your solution? Let me quote from your letter. You say, during the first contact, as you lay out your own protocol, an unhoused individual who declined the offer of shelter will be given a warning. During the second contact, a citation will be issued if the unhoused individual rejects the offer for shelter. The citation will later be dismissed after the offer for shelter has been accepted. A third visit with another rejected invitation will result in a transport to the jail, where the individual will be cited and released for a misdemeanor. The citation will be dismissed upon acceptance into a shelter. Mr. District Attorney, we are strictly enforcing the law. But how does anything you propose get people with mental health and substance abuse problems the help they need, either voluntarily or involuntarily? You could be of enormous help if you stopped the wedge politics and offered to partner instead, or merely accepted the offer that has already been made to partner with your city. You claim that my offer of partnership is unnecessary because you are already diverting people with mental illness and substance abuse into treatment. So let me now publicly ask you some questions, the same questions I asked you privately on July the 26th. How many people who commit theft or drug offenses in encampments have you prosecuted since you became DA? How many mental health diversion slots are currently available for people who you might prosecute and offer diversion to? How many people out of encampments have you diverted into treatment, compulsory treatment, by the way, since your term began? How many diversion cases can your courts, that you're partly responsible for, currently accommodate? Finally, your letter fails to acknowledge the federal court injunction that prohibits us from moving encampments or even enforcing our sidewalk ordinance. Has your team made you aware, Mr. District Attorney, of the injunction? One last thing. I want to quote from an email that our police chief, Kathy Lester, sent to city officials on July 18th, because I think that it is very revealing. If you give me just a moment. This is from the police chief, and I have her permission to share this. She wrote, "Good evening, this is July the 18th. I received a call from Adam Green, who is the assistant police chief, this evening, again July 18th, to share a conversation he had with DA Triplett, who is a DA Ho's chief assistant, DA Triplett this afternoon. Triplett called regarding homeless enforcement. He didn't demand, but he wanted us to consider citing for infractions of Sac City codes instead of misdemeanors, because he was concerned that the DA's office would not have the capacity to prosecute a large influx of misdemeanors." The police chief said, paused and said in her text or email, "The irony is not lost on me. The irony is not lost on any of us. Mr. District Attorney, hollow words on your letterhead won't solve this problem or even make it better. This is serious business, and some of us are hard at work trying to balance all of the competing interests, the need for a cleaner and safer city, in compliance enforcement, but also pathways to housing and treatment for people. Where are you? Either step up and partner or move aside. We aren't interested in your theater."